Hello, it's Peter Gregg from Miami, Florida. How's things in the world today? I had a friend over here, and we were talking about cameras, and I was taking some pictures and showing them the picture. I don't want to say if it's a her or a him, so I'll say him sometimes and her sometimes so nobody gets embarrassed. And I said, you know, you need to check the histogram when you're shooting because that is the current modern day meter. Oh, okay, they said, okay. So I asked, and I said, do you know how to read a histogram? And I was kind of joking, and that person looked at me and said, not really. I said, you don't know how to read a histogram? They said, not really. But I was afraid to and too embarrassed to admit it. So for all of those of you that always wanted to know how to read a histogram, but were afraid to ask, just like that book, when I was a teenager, everything you wanted to know about sex, but was afraid to ask, all of us guys went and bought that book, all right? We were in our teen years, man, you know what the rest that goes with it. Anyway, so for those of you that are everything you wanted to know about histograms but were afraid to ask, the histogram is on the back of your camera. And when you take a picture, you can bring up the picture and you can push the right button and bring up a histogram, all right? Now, do you know how to read it? If you know how to read it, you don't need to watch this video, but if you don't know how to read it, let me put on my glasses. I broke this and I still haven't gotten it fixed, so it feels very weird to have glass with one arm. Your histogram looks like that. And actually, let's get the magic marker, and the histogram looks like a box. Hello, can you see that? Nice box. Okay, forget that part of the box. And it basically shows you a chart in there. Now, do you know how to read that chart? Because that's the key to getting great pictures. The way you read that chart is the histogram might go something like this. Okay. And a lot of people don't know how to read that. Well, let me tell you how to read that. This is 0. And this is 255. Do you recognize those numbers? Those are the numbers when you look in Photoshop. That's the number of the brightness and which pixels it and how bright each pixel is. So a dark one would be 0. And a bright one, the whitest white, where there's absolutely no information, it's just solid white, is 255. And everything is in the middle. So you do not read a histogram up and down, like if you're an older person, you used to watch the meter for music, and it would go up and down and raise up and down. That's not how you read the histogram. You read the histogram from left to right, not up and down. Isn't that interesting? So let me clean this and get a new sheet of paper. And I'm going to have to get me one of those boards, like Karl Rove uses. And so let's draw our histogram box. This time I'm going to put it this way so I can draw it nicely, and then I'll show it to you. So if you have a very dark pixel, it would record right here. And if you had a pure white pixel, it would record right here. Okay? So if you had something that looks kind of like, let me move over here a little bit. If this histogram looks like this, how do we interpret that picture? There's a lot of dark stuff in the picture, and there's a lot of bright stuff in the picture, but there's nothing or very little in this range on a scale of 0 to 255 in this area. So this picture has a lot of blacks and darker tones to it, and has a lot of bright things. So it could be a picture of, this could be a picture of somebody wearing a white shirt and a black tie, and maybe even a sweater that's open. The sweater is black, so that's recording all the black pixels here. The shirt is white and it's very bright, so that's recording this. And it also is banging the wall on the right, okay? Now, what you do not want to do is you don't want, let's just use the whole pad, okay? So I don't have to draw the box over and over. You don't want a picture where all the pixels are slamming over to the 255, the brightest side. This is the darkest side, all right? Because that means the picture's overexposed. So your picture should be mostly in this area of the histogram. That means you've exposed this correctly. Am I getting it through, or am I getting you confused? So you're reading from left to right. You want to avoid hitting the right wall. you can hit the left wall, because if there's some blackness in the picture, that's going to be over here. So if all of your pixels are slamming up against the wall on this side over here, if all the pixels are slamming on the wall on this side, then your picture is probably overexposed. So a really good way to expose your picture is to take a picture of something, and of course you got to interpret, okay? And the histogram should probably try to stay in this area, but more to the right. That means it's properly exposed. If the histogram comes up and then drops off here and then goes like that, and it's just got a flat area, ignore this line here. That means that this area is blank. You're underexposed. And if you're underexposed and you try to raise up after, you know, in Photoshop or some other software, when you move this, when you raise up the exposure after you've picture is taken, you're going to move this over to the right. Okay, well and good. But you're also raising the noise that's in the picture, the grain and the noise. So that's why you want to expose a picture, okay, almost to the right wall, but not touching it too much. Now, let me give you an example. Here's a picture. Okay, I'll make the box. And we don't have a picture. I'm going to make an imaginary picture. All right, and the histogram looks something like that. What do you think this is a picture of? This would be a picture of some people or a bride in a white dress. Now, the white dress is going to show up a lot of white pixels, and you might have to overexpose it because the face might be somewhere in here. And the face needs to be properly exposed, so you might want to up this exposure a little bit more. So I'm breaking my own rule that you want to stay away from the side by knowing that the face is going to be in this area and that the white dress is registering this area here. So you want the face better exposed, and that's why there's a spot metering on your camera. Look at the instruction book. There's a spot metering section where if I was to spot meter, I would meter on my face, because the blackness or the darkness of my shirt might fool the meter, especially if I was like really, really close to the, like a close-up, all right? So if it was a close-up and there was a lot of black, my face might be overexposed. If I took up a close-up and I was wearing a white shirt, like just a t-shirt, all right, my face might be underexposed. So what do you do in that case? You can do two things. Either you can use the exposure compensation button and up it or minus it, or you can change to the spot metering. Spot, S-P-O-T, spot, like the dog. Dog, spot. You switch it to spot metering and meter on the face and lock it in. That way you'll get a good exposure of the face. So that's how you read a histogram. You read it from left to right. The left means it's very dark and the right means it's very bright. Now the reason this goes up and down is telling you how many pixels are actually recorded at that brightness level. If you had something that was very bright in the middle, you might have a spike right up the center and it might come right back down. And it might actually hit the top up above this frame way up there with my hands out. That doesn't mean the picture's overexposed. It means there's a lot of pixels in that column of that brightness. But if it's over here, that means that's the brightness of it. In the middle means it's kind of bright and kind of dark, 50-50 in the middle. So the pixels on this side are the brightest and the pixels on this side are the darkest. That's how you read a histogram. So you take a picture, you quickly look at the histogram, and you look at the right side and see how much it's slamming over to the right. If most of your picture is slamming over to the right, your shot is overexposed unless you've got a lot of white in the picture. So does that help clear things up, or did I get you totally confused? If I got you totally confused, write me down below and I'll do this whole lesson all over again and do another video. Peter Gregg from Miami, Florida, petergregg.com. I created the Zippy Bounce card and a Better Bounce card and the flashlight and the sensor sweep, and that's my commercial. Thanks, guys. Catch you later. Peter Gregg, Miami, Florida, over and out. Bye. I wonder if I can smoke this thing. Yeah.